kiss you, baby. You know you kiss the face of our God. Mary, did you know? Hey, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, family. Welcome, welcome, welcome to this place that we know is called the Mental House. With your host, a newly ordained minister, Khadija. I'd like to say this first and foremost, because this is a story that is so sad on so many levels. So y'all remember the boy, right, who was 10, who shot his mom for refusing to buy that little VR headset? Okay. They said when they talked to him on the phone, you know, all he is talking about his gadgets and his laptops, and he doesn't really want to talk about, nor does he. He just changes the subject when you talk about his mom. So, family members of accused 10-year-old Milwaukee, who spoke out in new interviews. They say he seems focused on his gadgets while charged with his mother's murder. Cops say he shot Kiana Mann dead for refusing to buy him a VR headset. The boy is being tried as an adult for first-degree murder, reckless homicide. Earlier, asked the judge to lower his $50,000 bail to $100 because that's the amount of money he has in his piggy bank. Wow. My God. They said that his family, this boy now is being charged with murder for killing his mom for refusing, again, to buy him a gadget. The boy is charged as an adult in Milwaukee, right here. Kiana Mann, 44, was shot in the face in their home, and the boy's aunt, Rhonda Reed, told Channel 4 WTMJ on Tuesday that when she talks to him in custody, he claims not to remember the shooting at all, you know, and then he quickly shifts the conversation to his favorite topic. When he calls, he's just like, make sure all my tablets and laptop and everything is properly packaged. Meanwhile, the boy's grandmother, Loretha Mann, says she can't bring herself to speak to him, telling the outlet, I hope one day I do, but right now, no. He took something very precious. I don't think a lot of y'all understand that it's going, you know, that the time is here. And sometimes we have to eat our young. And for a lot of us, that is a hard concept to even have to deal with. You know, Kiana was 44 years old, for y'all, those of y'all who don't know. And the prosecutors, they claim is that his mother refused to buy him a $500 Oculus VR headset. And when she did, because he had been begging for it, he shot her in the face and used her credit card to purchase one of the devices online. The boy then allegedly told his grandma he was sorry for killing his mother and asked where his package was. Earlier in the month, the boy's attorney, Angela Cunningham, asked for a bail reduction from $50,000 to $100,000, the amount he has left in his piggy bank. My thing is, and who wants him? I'm just going to be straight up. If this was, I don't know, he couldn't, I don't know if I could deal with it. Personally, I don't even want to see his face. If he killed my daughter, I'm like the grandma. Oh, Lord. The boy's grandmother, Loretha Mann, says she can't bring herself to speak to him. I hope I do one day, but right now, I don't want to speak to him at all. I don't even want to see his... Y'all got me twisted. We have spoken to him about his ability to post anything, Cunningham told the court. He told us about piggy banks with savings that he had from gifts, from birthday gifts, and scavenging through the kitchens and the couch, cushions in the couch, that he's been able to save up $100. Judge Jane Carroll denied the request and imposed a travel restriction on the minor that will go into effect if he manages to post bail, according to the Journal Sentinel. The child, according to family members, has huge rage issues, and hears imaginary people, has been charged with first-degree reckless homicide, and will be tried as an adult. Damn, this is a travesty. State law dictates that children as young as 10 will be charged as adults for serious crimes such as murder. He faces up to 60 years in prison if he's convicted. The fact that the boy will be tried as an adult has created some headaches for Carol, as she noted that all the usual factors when deciding bail conditions don't make a lot of sense when applied to a 10-year-old. She pointed out that the boy has no home of his own, no job, no real assets, and no way of attending court by himself or a prior criminal history. No, he's just insane. And, you know, I don't want to sound like I'm victim blaming or anything, but some of y'all spend a lot more time giving stuff to your kids as opposed to making them earn it, having them require it. And I don't know if they're showing too many signs of mental illness that you feel like, you know, I have no choice. But I'm going to tell you, this is so disgusting. Because, oh my God. So let me go ahead. Because he's being charged again as an adult, Carol has rejected the prosecutor's request that the boy be released to the custody of his family members if he don't post bail. The judge sided with the defense attorney, noted that such a condition wouldn't be required for an adult. The boy is currently being held at juvenile detention. This is when one of my dear friends worked, and he just retired from there. And he has not been publicly identified by police or prosecutors. He initially told police that the shooting was an accident. He claimed that man had walked in front of him while he was aiming at the wall to scare her, and he accidentally shot her in the head. See, he knows how to make excuses. I mean, he later said in the second interview, however, that he intentionally aimed at his mother Bishoyden before shooting her at their home on 87th Street near Hemlock around 7 a.m. on November 21st. I'm very familiar with the neighborhood. In fact, I have family members that lived in the neighborhood, and I'm just familiar with the family. This is what happens when you work in mental health and have mental health services and work in mental health dealing with children. After the shooting, listen, y'all. He put the gun in the closet and told his older sister, Brianna Moore, that their mother, who worked in behavior health, was dead. Moore then called 911. The boy was allowed to stay with family, and an initial release from police said the shooting was caused by the child playing with a gun. But a day later, the relatives called the police back. The boy's aunt said that when she collected him, he retrieved a set of house keys that contained a key to the gun's lockbox. when his aunt asked him about the shooting, the boy said that he pointed the gun at his mom and that she told him to put it down. The boy's aunt and sister said he never cried or showed any remorse and also had physically attacked his 7-year-old cousin the same day. The boy's family said he has concerning mental health issues, you think, and it has exhibited disturbing behavior in the past. I just want to know what y'all think, because I want to know what each and every one of y'all would do. Somebody co-sign. Somebody give me some feedback. Somebody tell me you give them away, whatever. Tell me what you would do if this was your child. When he was 4, the boy allegedly swung the family's puppy around by his tail. The 6 months ago, the family told police that he filled a balloon with flammable liquids and set it on fire, causing an explosion that burned furniture and the carpet. When he was asked why he did it, the boy allegedly said 2 sisters told him to do it. The boy told his family he hears 5 imaginary people talking to him, who he said are 2 sisters, an older woman, and 2 mean men. A sister also said in the complaint that her brother has a rage issue all his life and becomes very angry and acts out. If this is not one of the most saddest stories that some stuff has to be done about, I mean, I wouldn't wish this on my worst enemy. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy to give birth to a child that would kill you because you don't buy them what they want. Please tell me. I want to know what y'all think. Tell me what you think about this story, about this kid, about this situation. My heart goes out to the Mann family. Elder Man, Ruby Man, all of y'all, my family goes out to the man's, and all his relatives. I'll see y'all in the next video. This is just so painful.